Greetings, Eric Bakker, naturopath from New Zealand. Thanks for coming back, checking out my videos. We're talking about stool testing today. We're doing several videos on stool testing. So we're going to talk about doctors' data stool testing. So doctors' data labs are in Chicago. They're in Illinois, Chicago. I work with doctors' data now for over 20 years. I've had training by doctors' data. I've been to their labs. I know the company quite well. I know some of their technical people. They're brilliant. They always reply to my emails. I've sometimes had some interesting outcomes where I've had a patient, you know, with enough income who's actually had stool tests done by both labs at exactly the same time, which is interesting. Or I've authorized a doctor's data stool test, whereas previously I had one done by Genova Diagnostics or Great Plains, but now they've got a doctor's data one. And I've found sometimes to be quite conflicting results. So I've emailed doctor's data. As I mentioned, I get a reply and get a great reply back, but I never get replies back from Genova Labs, which disappoints me. I'll just shut this blind. It's a bit bright today. Yeah, so it is a bit disappointing when you don't hear back from these guys. But doctor's data, never a problem. Explaining exactly why there was a discrepancy, you know, in their test result, why they actually showed to have high levels of beneficial bacteria in their test, whereas the Genova showed no beneficial bacteria. And that was a question that they replied to and explained exactly why their methodology showed, you know, that there were viable counts there, as opposed to not being. So the reply was very good. So I prefer to work with a lab I've worked with for a long, long time. I know the technical guy there. I get outstanding results with it. And also I think the pricing is quite good. So I believe that Genova are pricier, they're more expensive. Genova, we're going to talk about in a minute in another video, but I always stay with Doctors Data Labs because it's my preference. I believe that technically they're superior. They've spent quite a lot of money on lab upgrades. They've got the right kind of PhDs on staff. They've been around a long, long time. And so I'll stay with that lab. If something works, you know, why reinvent the wheel? I'm very happy with it. And I think for, you know, the $400 that you're spending for a lab test, when it comes to their top level stool test, you're getting an incredible amount of information back. Plus also you're getting it back in a particular way that's easy to read and easy to act upon that information. Whereas I look at other lab tests, the results can be a bit difficult to interpret and go more into specific species, for example, which doesn't interest me that much. So the doctor's data test, the first page basically is the microbiology screen. So we've really got the beneficial bacteria, we've got the imbalanced bacteria and the dysbiotic bacteria all on, you know, the front page up the top. So in one quick overview, we can immediately see what the bacteria are doing. Then we've also on that page, we've got the mycology culture. So they've actually cultured the stool samples to see if they can grow any live viable yeast from this stool sample. On the second page, we've got the parasitology page. So each of the three samples is independently tested for the presence of parasites and also for dead yeast. So yeah, and then the report keeps going on and on. Then we have digestion markers, we have absorption markers, we have immunology markers, we have inflammation markers. There's several pages of very useful information on this report laid out in such a fashion that one of those reports I can interpret usually in less than 5 minutes now. I've had so many of these reports in my hands. I find reports from other companies a little bit more difficult to interpret. Information can be scattered all over the place. Sometimes some of these markers are missing, they're not quite there. And as I say, it is also more expensive to test with other labs, and sometimes, you know, a couple of $100 more. So that can make a big difference. Doctors Data have been doing stool testing a long, long time now, and I believe they're one of the top experts in America for stool testing. The two top labs I would rank in the US for stool testing would be Doctors Data and also Genova Diagnostics. That would be the two top labs, in my opinion. So if you're going to spend, you know, upwards of $300-$400 on a test, I believe that it should be with one of those two labs, because you're dealing with the right people, the right experience. And if you do the test properly, as I mentioned in a previous video, you know, with the withholding period observer supplements, you're going to get the right kind of result as well. And as long as you're working with a practitioner who knows how to interpret these results and put a good protocol into place for you, you're going to get a great outcome as well. So if you're going to do stool testing, make the wise decision to either invest in either a doctor's data test or a Genova Diagnostics test, because those would be the two top companies, in my opinion, that you should be working with. So hope that gives you a bit of information. Thanks for tuning in.